birthday! Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time here, my name is Tressa, and I'm a fifth grade teacher in Alberta, Canada. I make lots of teaching and learning videos here on YouTube, and I would love to have you consider subscribing and following along. All right, you guys, it is my birthday today. Well, actually not today, but when you're seeing this, it will be the day of my birthday. And this year I will be turning 28, so I thought it would be fun to have a video for you where I share 28 things about me. I feel like I don't post a lot of personal stuff on my channel. I really tend to keep it at school in my life as a teacher. But I thought this would be kind of fun and a great way for you to get to know me and help us to create our community here on YouTube. Anyways, I have a list with 28 facts, so I have lots to share, so let's get right into it. Okay, so I split it up into four categories. So the first category is gonna be the kind of more obvious one, and that is teacher facts about me. This second category is where I'll get a little bit personal and tell you about myself. The third category is going to be lifestyle, and the final category will be favorites, where I tell you some of my very favorite things. Okay, so to start off, I have been a teacher for 5 years. I got my teaching job right out of graduating from an education program. So that was 5 years ago now. This is my fifth year as a teacher. My second fact is that I have taught both grades 1 and grade 5. I taught grade 1 my first 2 years before I got bumped up to grade 5, and this is my third year in grade 5. My absolute favorite subject to teach is math, and it's kind of funny because if you know me, you know that I personally do not very much like math, and math is not one of my strong suits, especially growing up. I had a lot of tears over math, but I feel like that's partly why I like it so much, is because I truly struggled with it. So it's one of those areas that I really like to help kids to understand so that they don't feel the way that I always felt about math. I have only taught at one school in my career, but I have moved classrooms 3 different times. So 3 classroom moves in 5 years. I feel like I'm pretty much a pro at it by now. So this is kind of a relevant and neat fact, is that I actually got this job offer for the job that I currently have on my birthday. So it just turned out randomly that the assistant superintendent of our district at the time phoned me, and it was my birthday when she offered me this job. I always knew I wanted to be a teacher. Like, I honestly cannot remember a time in my life when I didn't want to be a teacher. All of the jobs that I've had included like babysitting, nannying, anything that was like a caregiver was something that I was always drawn to. So I always knew that I wanted to be a teacher. And my last fact for this category is that my very favorite part of teaching is building honest relationships with kids. So I feel like a lot of people say like, oh, the best part is the kids. And it really is, but I think it's not just building relationships with them, because some relationships can be very surface level. But when I truly feel like I have connected with my class, and it actually takes a couple of months. So if you're a new teacher or you're hoping to be a teacher one day, there's actually this period of time when I feel like this happens to me every year. I worry that like I just am not bonding with my class, or I don't have the same connection with this class that I had with a class in the past. And so that moment when you know for sure you have built like a true and honest relationship with your class is such a game changer. And it's that moment when you really feel like you are connecting and they like you, you like them, they respect you, you respect them. And that connection is just so strong, and it is on a completely different level than it is in the beginning of the year. And it is truly magical. My absolute favorite part of teaching. Okay, so now for the personal category. Nothing really juicy here, but if you want to get to know me on, I guess, like a more personal level, perhaps these facts will allow you to do that. So I currently live in Alberta, but I'm actually from the smallest province in Canada. So if you're not familiar with Canadian geography, the smallest province is called Prince Edward Island, and it is extremely tiny. My necklace that I'm wearing right now is actually of PEI, and I was born and raised there, and I actually didn't leave PEI, like not even to go to school or anything, until that time when I got my job here and my dad and I drove across the country and I got settled here for my teaching job. My second fact is that I come from a family of five. So it's my mom, my dad, my older brother, me, and my younger brother. So my mom actually passed away from cancer when I was 11 years old. She was sick for a good portion of my life, but I am so blessed to have had the time that I had with her. She was truly one of those people who was like put on earth to be a mom. Like she was just the most amazing mom. And she still is. Like she still inspires me even though she's not here on earth. And I just truly love her and I'm so grateful for the time that we did have together. And my brothers and I are both very close. I have an older brother who's about 2 years older than me and a younger brother who's younger than me by about 3.5 years. And we all look very much alike, but we are all extremely different. I'm really blessed that my brothers and I always got along. Like obviously when we were younger, we fought and we argued and things like that, but they were also always my best friends and the people that I played with every single day. And I'm so just grateful to have had the opportunity like to have siblings. Like I can't imagine being an only child because my brothers like really were my built-in best friends and we still support each other so much. And I cherish the relationship now in like such a different way, but I'm blessed to have those people that I'm just still so close with and I can count on them for anything. I have a 9-year-old dog. She is a Samoyed and I will put a picture of her right here. Her name is Kaya. She actually lives in PEI with my dad. When I moved out to Alberta, we just decided it was the best choice because I wasn't exactly sure what my life would look like here, like how much free time I would have. And I was going to be living by myself as well. So having her to have like my dad and my family, my dad's retired. He was a teacher for 38 years. And so my dad and Kaya are just the absolute best of friends. And I've actually just started looking into getting my own Samoyed to have out here with me in Alberta. If you are ever looking for a breed of dog, I highly recommend Samoyeds. Like she is the absolute best thing on the entire planet. Like the sweetest, friendliest, kindest thing that I've ever met. And I was actually scared of dogs and that's why my family allowed us to get one, was because I really needed to get over that fear. Like it is a little bit paralyzing to be scared of dogs because they're just everywhere. So my dad let us get a dog and he said it had to be a Samoyed. So we got Kaya and I just love her so much. So if you're familiar with love languages, I thought I would share my love language because I think that that's a really interesting concept. And I've actually read the books and I highly recommend reading the books if you have only like done the quiz online and like heard what other people are talking about love languages. I do actually recommend reading the books because it's really interesting and it's beyond love. Like it's really about relationships and how you can form relationships with others and how you reach out to other people and they can reach out to you. So my personal love language is acts of service by far. So you may not know this because I'm out here on the internet posting videos about myself, but I am an extremely introverted person. I really get my energy like being by myself and I have always been like that. Like I very much like to be alone and it takes me a really long time to warm up to people, which can be really quite difficult, especially forming like adult friendships. But I have a couple of close friends that I hold so near and dear to my heart, but I am definitely an introvert. Another one of those cool tests that is circling around the internet is Enneagrams. I think I'm saying that right. I'm doing my best. But I am an Enneagram number 1 and number 2. Those are like my top 2. So number 1, if you're familiar, is the perfectionist and number 2 is the giver. And I feel like I didn't even need to take the quiz to find that out about myself, but I have taken the quiz numerous times and it doesn't change. I am a perfectionist and I am a giver and that is so true about me. And I even understand the order. Like I actually have issues in my life of like being a perfectionist. So I think it's like a blessing and a curse at the same time. But as well with like the giver, that can also be a blessing and a curse because you do kind of always strive to give to others and it can be really hard to find the energy to do that. So it's interesting when you read about all the Enneagrams and you find out, I feel like they all have like their pros and cons, right? But if you're interested, there are a ton of tests online and it's really cool to take the test and then find out like, whoa, like, yes, that is me to a T. All right, moving on to the third section, and that is lifestyle. And if you've been following me for a little while, you probably know a couple of these facts already because I do kind of sneak some lifestyle facts in throughout my day, because anytime I'm sharing like a day in the life or a week in my life as a teacher, obviously my lifestyle plays a role in that. But these are the seven facts I will share with you about my lifestyle. So fact number one, I have been a vegetarian for my whole life. I was raised that way. I struggled with it growing up, like when you go to a birthday party and everyone has pepperoni pizza, like I was very frustrated to be a vegetarian. But now that I'm an adult, I think it's so cool and quite good for you if you do it properly. And I definitely plan on raising my own family as vegetarians one day. So my second fact in this category, I was a competitive figure skater for many years growing up. I loved figure skating. I figure skated 3 to 4 times a week. And I was an ice dancer with my best friend, Emily. We were best friends. We did everything together. So we were a perfect match. I also competed like solo, doing routines and things like that. And then I was also on a synchronized figure skating team. So that was a huge, huge part of my childhood. Then like as I got older and the possibility of playing like school sports kind of came to be, my dad was actually a phys ed teacher, so school sports were like a huge part of my life even before I was able to play them myself. But in terms of school sports, I played volleyball, soccer, basketball, badminton, rugby, and I ran cross country and track and field. So sports have always been a major part of my life. I love, love, love to write, and I always have. When I was younger, I used to write poems while I was trying to fall asleep, and I would like keep a notepad on my bedside table to like write down the poems I came up with. And it actually ended up being really special because I was able to write like a poem for my mom, and it's in the cancer center in PEI right now. And just a way of like me honoring her, but I actually gave it to her as a gift for Mother's Day one year. It was just like one of my best methods to communicate with people. So anytime I was like grateful for someone, I wrote them a poem, and it also helped me to fall asleep every night. So I haven't written poems in a long time, but I do still continue to write. I would actually love to create a blog. That would be like a goal in the near future of mine. So we'll see how that comes to light. I love baking, so I really enjoy trying new like healthy recipes. So my very favorite cooking blogs that I have found so far for that are Cookie and Kate, Chocolate Covered Katie, and Lowe's Healthy Life. And I actually went to school with Lauren from Lowe's Healthy Life. So absolutely, I highly recommend checking out those accounts, especially if you have a sweet tooth like me, but you'd like to like healthify baking. Those are great accounts and they have a ton of delicious recipes. I love to read, and I'm not super picky about what I read. If you're not new to my channel, you know that I read during silent reading every single day with my kids, and we always have a novel study on the go, and then I also read picture books all the time. Like, I truly believe books are powerful and magical and all that good stuff. But my own favorite books to read are definitely romance novels. Like growing up, I always was reading the Nicholas Sparks books like all through high school and university. And then I loved like reading the book and watching the movie. And I still love doing that. I definitely don't find as much time to read like adult books now. I am often reading like something that I'm having in mind for like my next read aloud or something in my classroom. But I do love, love, love to read. I get overwhelmed by mess and disorder like big time. It's definitely my perfectionist self, but I like things to be neat and tidy and clean. And I'm not like an everyday cleaner. I'm more so like I let something get to a point where like I'm going to lose my mind, and then I'll spend like a whole day tidying up and cleaning. But cleaning is very like therapeutic for me. And my last fact for this category is that I love interior design and decorating. Those are some of my favorite YouTube videos to watch. I have a Pinterest account full of it, and I love following also Instagram accounts where people are into interior design. I just bought my first ever house last year, and so it's been really fun getting the chance to decorate it. It's super expensive, so I've been like attacking things room by room, but it has been really fun to get to like create a space that truly reflects me and who I am. And I definitely enjoy that about teaching as well, like making my classroom somewhere that I love to be. All right, you guys, my very last category is favorites, where I'll share just some of my preferences with you. So very first one, super important, my favorite TV show. I cannot decide. I think my number one would be New Girl. If you have not watched New Girl, it is amazing. It's almost like a modern day Friends, Don't get at me over that. I like Friends too, but I did really enjoy New Girl. It's super funny and just keeps you laughing. It's lighthearted and just so enjoyable, especially after a hard day of teaching. But my close second would be Gilmore Girls. I actually recently rewatched that and it was like devastating when it was over again. My favorite supper food is burritos, and pet peeve of mine is when people ask you what your favorite food is, because like, give me a category. I love eating, so just asking me in general what my favorite food is very difficult. My favorite supper food is burritos. My favorite like dessert baked good would be donuts. And then my favorite treat is the Reese's Outrageous peanut butter cups. So not just Reese's peanut butter cups, but the Reese's peanut butter cups that also have the Reese's pieces inside of them. Dairy Queen actually had a blizzard that was a Reese's Outrageous for the longest time. And a little bit of an embarrassing story, but I got that every single time that I went to Dairy Queen for like the longest time. And I only went to Dairy Queen for that. Like, I was not interested in any of their other blizzard flavors. And then there was a time that I went through the drive-thru and I ordered a Reese's Outrageous blizzard and they informed me that they no longer make them. And I cried. So that's embarrassing, but that's how good it was. And I'm actually devastated. Like, I don't get go to Dairy Queen anymore. So bring back the Reese's Outrageous Blizzard, definitely. My favorite workout style, I love fitness. Working out, like, that is my number one like stress reliever, my number one hobby. I often work out before and after school, but my number one like workout style would be HIIT. I just love like getting your heart rate up, getting a good sweat on, and it is seriously the best way to like decompress before or after a day. Often like when I work out before school, it's to get my energy up, and then after school, it's like to get rid of all the extra energy and stress that I'm carrying in my body after a day at school. My absolute favorite color is blush pink, and you often see me wearing it. It is the color of like my bedroom. I'm pretty sure if my classroom could be blush pink, I would make it that color, but I don't know if everyone loves that color, so like, it's fine. But my phone case, my laptop case, my water bottle, so much of the stuff I own is that color, and I just truly love it. I really enjoy going shopping. Again, I find it to be like a good stress reliever. Spending money is not a stress reliever, but shopping I really enjoy. And my very favorite store is Winners. We have a Winners here. If you're not from Canada, Winners is like TJ Maxx, Marshalls. I love going to Winners, and I probably go like, I've been better now, but I used to go like 2 or 3 times a week. Now I definitely go to Winners once a week. Like, everyone who works there knows me for sure. Kind of going off of that, my favorite clothes to wear are definitely activewear and loungewear. I could live in that kind of stuff. It's actually like paining me to be wearing jeans on a Sunday, but I will put them on for this video and they will literally be off again in like 10 minutes. But I love wearing activewear. Like, I could wear activewear every single day. And I absolutely love loungewear, especially now that loungewear is like in style and there are so many cute options available with like matching tops and bottoms. I'm just so into it. Love, love, love loungewear. And my very last fact to share with you today is that my very favorite place in this whole world is my family's cottage. And I am so blessed to have had a cottage growing up. It was a place where my family got to go for the whole summer. My mom was a stay-at-home mom and my dad was a teacher, so he had summers off. So we often moved into our cottage in like May, and we would stay till like late September or early October before we moved back to our house. So it truly was like a second home for me. But we had a cottage that had like a bank and then the harbor, and so the beach was right there every single day. And I had so many experiences that were so positive in the summer having that cottage, and I got to be so close with my family because our cottage was a lot smaller than our home. So we lived in tight quarters for many months of the year, but we also spent so much time outside. But I know it was definitely my mom's happy place, and it's the same for me. And I'm so excited one day to be able to make some memories with my own family at that same cottage. All right, guys, there you have it. That is 28 things about me for my 28 years of life. So before you go, I would love to know if we have any similarities. Was there anything I said that totally applied to you that you could relate with? Please leave a comment down below. I would love to know something about you. If you enjoyed today's kind of different video, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe if you're new, because I have lots of great content coming at you in the next couple weeks. And I will see you in my next one.